it's me, KG from the KG Lifestyle. Today I am finally recording a highly requested video on my skin and my skincare. I'm pretty simple, at least I think I'm pretty simple. I use a lot of products, or I use like 6 to 7 products, but I don't use them daily. So my daily regimen is very simple, and you know, I have things here and there for different things that I need, like a mask or something like that, which I'll go through in just a moment. But I wanted to just show you guys my skin. Hopefully you can see really well with this camera. I did recently have a little breakout up here, and I don't wear like liquid foundation. I don't wear heavy anything, so all I have on now is MAC Mineralize Skin Finish. And I've dotted the concealer, their Pro Longwear Concealer. I have a couple of blemishes or dark spots here and a couple of here that I always cover up. So here, here, and then my skin finish is all I use. And by the end of the day, usually the oil in my T-zone is like already taking care of that. So very light makeup. Of course I have eyeliner on. What I'm gonna do is actually take you guys through what I do. So I'm gonna wash my face now, and I'm gonna tell you how I'm gonna do the different things that I'm gonna do. So usually I'll wash my face with one of two things. This is the Neutrogena Naturals Makeup Remover and Fresh Cleansing Soap. So it's a liquid, and I'll show you how I just use it. It's all natural, obviously, and it completely removes makeup and gently cleanses for refreshingly clean skin. So no harsh chemicals, sulfates, parabens, all that stuff is not in here. So this is one of my favorite soaps. If I don't have this or use this, I use black soap. And this is the one from actually Shea Moisture. Shea Moisture uses a black soap, or they produce or manufacture a black soap. And it's almost gone, but usually it comes in a really thick bar. Lasts forever, because I've had 2 of the bars, and I've probably had 2 of them all year. So this is my second one that's almost down, and I'll get another one. I just think it cleanses your skin really well, no harsh chemicals again, and it smells really good too. And it's, you know, got natural stuff in it, you know, different ingredients that will help to cleanse your skin. So really good cleansers. I also sometimes use this scrub as a cleanser. This is the St. Ives Apricot Scrub. I have a bigger one in my shower, but this is the one I'll take on trips, especially trips to like the south, like Atlanta. I get a lot of oil in my skin, in my T-zone, when I am in like a humid area. So I'll take this and actually use it as my cleanser. I make sure not to apply it too much to my eye area, because I don't want to, you know, damage that skin, because it's very delicate there. So I kind of stay away from this area, and I'll just make sure I get my T-zone really well and my nose really well, because that's where some of my blackheads and whiteheads will try to stay. So yeah, this is the Apricot Scrub Blemish and Blackhead Control, and it has a little bit of salicylic acid, which is really great for acne as well. So this is another one that I technically use as a cleanser. As a toner, I actually use Witch Hazel. I buy the regular, I don't know, $1.20 Witch Hazel from Target or Walmart, and I actually put it in a spray bottle like this, and I'll spray it on my face and use a wiping pad just to wipe it off. And that gets any additional makeup that I had on. Usually there's not much on the pad when I use my toner. It's just around the edges where I didn't really get my face clean as much as I, or as well as I should have. And so that's what the toner helps me do, and just make sure I really dry out and remove anything that was on my skin previously. After I use the toner, I kind of fan it, because it kind of, after all that washing and then the toner, at least my skin really hydrated. So I just fan it a little bit, and then I'll put this on. This is the Dual Treatment Moisturizer from Target. It's the Up and Up brand, so their store brand. and this one is oil-free, compares to Clean and Clear Dual Action Moisturizer. I have gotten the Clean and Clear Dual Action Moisturizer, but I didn't like it as much as I like the store brand. So I love this stuff. I actually found out about this moisturizer from Kelly 101 on YouTube here. She's really, really beautiful, great skin, and she's, yeah. So I definitely went out and purchased this after I saw her skincare regimen, and it's been my favorite moisturizer throughout all seasons. Now, when I do have problems, like the one I had up here, and if you watch my vlog, you already know, this is Mario Betscu. I'm not sure how to pronounce this. This is the drying lotion, and I get mine from Nordstrom's, and this is $17 a bottle, and it's really small. There's two ingredients in here. I don't know what this is, but I guess it maintains the lotion down here. So you just stick a Q-tip down into this and dab it into the lotion. You take it out, and then you apply it to your blemish to dry it out. Usually you want to do this and apply it to a breakout that you've already kind of extracted. So if you've already popped the pimple or whatever, and you dab, you know, make sure the pimple's clear of all the pus and everything else that's still kind of trying to come out. When it's almost gone, I take the Q-tip, dab it in here, and dab it on my my breakout. And it stings a little bit, but that's how you know it's working. It's actually getting into the pore that was, you know, pussy or infected or whatever, and it dries it out fast. Like, if I pop a pimple the night before and then put this on there, it's like 95, maybe 90% gone in the morning. Like, it's already dried out. I don't have to worry about it coming back or, you know, populating more of the white stuff. So great stuff. I love this drying lotion. And if you do use this, just make sure you don't put the same Q-tip back in here, because you've already infected it with your blemish. So don't do that. The other thing I got is also from Nordstrom's, and this is the mask that I use. And sometimes I'll put this on a pimple that's not yet ready to be popped. So this is Kiehl's Rare Earth Deep Pore Cleansing Mask, and it's got really good stuff in here. I remember when I first bought it, but it's a really, really, really effective mask. It will take out all your blackheads and all your whiteheads, at least it does for me. So I try to do this. I haven't done a full face mask in a really long time, but usually I'll put it in my T-zone if I feel like I just had a really oily day, and, you know, even after I cleanse my skin, I'm like, okay, I need something else. I'll put it right in my chin area and in my T-zone area just to kind of dry it out, and then you can wipe it off with warm water. I do sometimes leave this on, like I said, on some of my blemishes overnight, just so that it kind of dries them out or keeps them from coming, especially if they're not yet ready to be popped and, you know, I can't apply my drying lotion because nothing's gonna get in there. The skin hasn't broken yet. So after, if I use this and it goes away, great. If I use this and it still comes up, you know, on my skin, then I will pop it and then insert this into it. And that's it. Those are the things I use regularly. So the only things I use every day are my soap, my toner, and my lotion here. Every day. These are the three things that I use. And, you know, interchangeably this, depending on how I think my skin is feeling. Sometimes I'll use the Rare Earth, like I just explained, and then only when I have a blemish do I use the Mario Betscu drying lotion.
So here we go. I just applied one pump of the Neutrogena Naturals to my hand, and I'm washing my face. I just gently rub away the makeup and make sure my eyeliner is off and everything like that. That's why I love this soap, because it also serves as a makeup remover. To rinse, I rinse my face with warm water 3 times and then 3 times with cold water, and that just kind of seals my pores and makes my skin silky smooth. Recently, I've added the PMD, or the personal microderm, to my regimen. So I do this once a week, and I really, really do love this product because it makes my skin really smooth. It gets rid of those dead skin cells that are sitting on top that I can't get rid of with the apricot scrub or the mask, and it's really easy to use. It's actually very comparable to the professional microdermabrasion treatments, but it's much cheaper and it's easier to do just because you're at home. Another cool thing about the PMD, or the personal microdermabrasion, is that it comes with two different pads. So the pad I'm using now is for my face, and then there's another one for your body. After each treatment, I use toner and my lotion that I showed you guys earlier. That just replenishes the cells again and allows your skin to kind of recover from the microdermabrasion. You can also use a serum or a cream. And the instructional video that comes with it is pretty good. It tells you exactly what to do. After each treatment, I always feel like my skin is really smooth, almost like deep treatments for my hair. I really feel like it's just something I have to do every once in a while to get all of those dead skin cells off of my skin. If you guys are interested in purchasing a PMD or a personal microdermabrasion, then there's a discount code in the description box. You can go to www.personalmicroderm.com if you're interested in purchasing. And that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this skincare regimen video. Let me know if you guys have any questions or if you have any suggestions. Thank you. Peace and blessings.
The only things, of course, that I use every day is my soap, my toner, and my lotion. So, whoop!